Hi there, everybody, and welcome along once again to Llandaff Cathedral for this organ recital which celebrates the life and work of the great French organist composer Louis Vierne. Vierne was born in Poitiers on the 8th of October 1870 and was the son of a journalist. He was, from birth, almost blind due to congenital cataracts and had various operations throughout his life to try and correct his sight, none of which were wholly successful. The young Vierne first heard the organ being played, in fact by César Franck, when he was around age 11 in 1881. César Franck then took him on as a private pupil, and Vierne moved up to the Paris Conservatoire, where he graduated in 1894, winning all the top prizes. During this period of time, he was assistant to Vidor at the great Parisian church of Saint-Sulpice, and then became organist of Notre-Dame Cathedral in 1900, a post which he held until his death, famously in 1937, whilst giving his 1,750th organ recital there. Vierne had a lot to deal with throughout his life. His eldest son and his brother were both killed during the First World War, and he suffered a serious accident in Paris in 1906, which almost meant that he had to have one of his legs amputated. All of these trials and tribulations can be found to influence his music and his writing, of course, and I hope that you enjoy some of the things that we've chosen to show off tonight from his quite large output for the organ in particular. So we're going to begin now with a movement from the Second Symphony, which Vierne completed in 1902. And it's a particularly bombastic opening to the recital. Starts on full organ and with a very dark theme indeed. So here is the Allegro from the Second Symphony.
Thank you.
So the next piece that we're going to hear is the second movement of the Third Symphony, which was composed in 1911 and finished while Vierne was on holiday with the Dupré family. And in fact, the symphony is dedicated to Marcel Dupré. This is the second movement, as I say, and it opens with a very slow oboe melody, quite a chromatic melody and quite a forlorn one, which then contrasts with a middle section which we'll hear on the foundation stops. The opening melody then returns later on in the piece, and this time it's accompanied by some very quick moving semi-quaver figurations in the left hand on the choir flutes. The piece comes to a very peaceful conclusion in a major key. So this is the Cantilène from Symphony No. 3.
Thank you.
The next three pieces come as a little set, and I'm very pleased to be joined by mezzo-soprano Olivia Gomez to sing two of them. The first is a very early work of Vierne's from 1886, a setting of the very familiar words to Ave Maria, and it's a particularly simple setting of these words. After that, we're going to hear a piece from the 24 pieces in a freestyle, which Vierne wrote to be able to be played on a large instrument, such as ours here at the cathedral, or on one of very modest proportions, indeed just a harmonium, which we would have found in lots of churches in rural France during that time. Each of the 24 pieces is in a different key, one for each of the 24 major and minor keys that we can achieve through chromatic notes on the keyboard. And this one is in D major, and it conjures up particularly thoughts of early 20th century France through a very flowing and lyrical melody. After that, we're going to hear one of Vierne's later works, which shows off a slightly more mature compositional style, and which he wrote between 1930 and 31. It's entitled Les Angélus and is in three movements, of which this is the third one. The Angélus being the set of prayers which are said at 6 o'clock in the morning, midday, and 6 p.m. in the evening. And these are all religious texts which call to mind those particular times of prayer. At the very outset of the piece, you'll hear the tolling of the bell, just three unison notes, which then pervade all the way through the rest of the piece.
Thank you.
Next, we're going to hear Allegro Vivace from the First Symphony, which Vierne started in 1898 and finished in 1899, and the symphony is dedicated to Alexandre Guillaumin. It's a particularly sort of impish piece, very quick staccato figurations for the flute stops in the outer two sections, which is contrasted then with a beautiful lyrical solo in the middle for the trumpet. And sometimes you'll hear the solo in canon with the feet as well. So this is the Allegro Vivace from the First Symphony.
Thank you.
Next, we're going to hear the very beautiful romance from the Fourth Symphony, which Vierne wrote in 1914, just as war was breaking out in Europe. The Fourth Symphony is generally a very dark and foreboding piece, therefore, but the romance offers a shaft of light into this particular symphony. And it starts off with some very flowing manual figurations which accompany a solo on the pedals on the 8-foot clarinet stop. The middle section of the piece calls to mind some of the other movements of the symphony, which are highly chromatic and, as I say, very dark and foreboding in nature. But this then again makes way for the very beautiful opening melody to come back at the end of the piece, this time on a flute stop. And you'll see also in the camera some interesting double pedaling in this piece, where the right foot mirrors the melody in quavers and the left foot sustains the bass. But the end of the piece brings a real sense of warmth in a key of D flat major to this otherwise foreboding, rather dark symphony.
Thank you.
of Pièces de Fantaisie were published in 1926 and 27, with six pieces in each, and this particular piece comes from the second set. Vierne's rather bombastic and joyous Hymn to the Sun features an opening and an ending on the full organ. In the middle, a slightly more subdued section centered around just one note with unison writing for hands and feet, then builds through a great crescendo back to a statement of the opening theme once again for the end of the piece.
Thank you.
So there we have it. That brings to a close today's recital, which I hope that you've enjoyed. The easiest way to keep up to date with what's going on here at the Cathedral is to sign up to our e-newsletter. And the way that you can do that is scrolling along the bottom of the screen as I'm speaking to you now. We do really hope that you've enjoyed today's recital, and if you feel that you can make a donation to the work of the Cathedral during this period of time, we would be very grateful. It's very easy to do that by text giving, and again, you can see how to do that scrolling along the bottom of the screen as I'm talking to you now. There are other events and recitals in the planning for the months ahead, and we hope to be able to bring you much more of Llandaff Cathedral online as we go through the rest of 2020 and into 2021. Thanks for tuning in. Look forward to playing to you again very soon.